Hello! Welcome back to Making Art with Virginia. This is How to Draw a Fox Part 2, getting the picture from the reference photo to the paper. We're going to use a grid. I think it'll be maybe an inch, maybe 2 inches of a grid. And it's going to be an 8x10 drawing that we end up with from an 8x10 photo that I've printed out. So please stay tuned to find out how to use a grid to transfer your picture. Here we have a pad of Strathmore 500 charcoal paper, 24 sheets, 100% cotton, natural white. Well, I think of that cover as natural white, and this is cream color. This is the paper that came out of it. And it has a smooth side and a more textured side, or it appears to me to have that, and I'm going to use the smooth side. I'm using a plain old pencil. Well, not plain, Ticonderoga. I love Ticonderoga. Anyway, we're going to measure out 8x10. This is 9, so I need to take an inch off, and that would be a half inch off each side. I'm not going to cut it, I'm just going to draw the outside lines and tape it to my board here. And very, very lightly draw lines so that you can erase them later. Now this is, well, they're saying 12. They're giving you room to get rid of this stuff. So we want 10. So we'll take an inch off here and an inch off here. And an inch off here and an inch off here. Very lightly drawing the line. By the way, these lines do not have to be perfect. Nothing has to be perfect. This is art. Let's see, that's 8 inches, not perfect. By 10 inches, 8x10. And then I'm going to measure out my inch grid. That doesn't need to be perfect either. The fox's mother is not going to be seeing the picture, so it doesn't have to be a perfect likeness. It just has to look like a fox. I'm very lightly touching the paper with the pencil, because I don't want to make an indentation in the paper. So we're lightly doing our lines. Now we'll measure this way. When I drew my horse, I did not use a grid or anything like that. But now I want to show people how to use a grid. A grid can come in very handy for many things. There's nothing wrong with using a grid, or with tracing, or with using a projector, or whatever you want to do. There are those who say that you cannot learn to draw by using a grid or by tracing. They may be right, I don't know. But from the very beginning, well, not the very beginning, but when I started getting serious about portraits, I was using a grid of our gridded drawing paper taped to the board. Here's our gridded reference photo. Willow charcoal. What you do is you count your squares, like 1, 2, 3. In the third square up, we've got his leg starting. I'm marking where my corners are. 1, 2, 3. So we've got legs starting here. There. And there. We're here. So one, two, down here, this is white.
1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, there's our sketch. This is a little, that's a little darker. We'll fill that in a minute. This is just a sketch. We will fill in details later. I hate to rub in those eyes, but I guess I'll have to. There we go. Okay, now what we do, got the sketch, got as much of the sketch as we need right now. We will erase the grid right now. Get that out of the way, because it looks like a fox. It looks good enough. This kneaded eraser doesn't leave crumbs like those plastic erasers, which have their place. Yes, plastic erasers have their place, and I like them. That's why I have them. But they do leave nasty, nasty crumbs. And you don't have to get all the grid out of there, just enough. The grid has its place, but it can also be irritating and in the way. Clean out the charcoal from the kneaded eraser by kneading it, making a nice clean spot. Now we'll continue with the sketching. Finish up the sketch before we continue with the drawing. Okay, this is just the sketch for now. I'm getting carried away. I need to stop while it's a sketch.